So cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
I know. Just gonna take a picture of that real fast. Oh, okay, it is not enough. run real fast to the house. That was bad move from me. Also, how do you like my new look? Like, I wanted to do something with this red
the cold
wig.
Was burning Carl.
I know.
He would not hold up much longer. He had to warm himself.
I know. We'll go into that house and put the light. Please be unlocked.
The place looked more like a pigsty than a house.
Oh shit, we don't have any.
The stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air.
Do we have any? We need some wood. I know, Carl, just a little bit longer. Is you're not gonna die in this wilderness. Okay, that's good. Okay. Just gonna check out my inventory, and I think that I need to put out some stuff. We don't need that, I think. Consumable. Maybe we should use some. Let's the smoke up in here. Gonna feel way better. Something has happened here. Why was this one cleaner? Was our within reach? Some awful music there. Righty. A gun rack. Yeah, a gun rack.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death.
Okay.
Carl knew right away that the owner of this place wasn't a copper collector. No, this was a junkman's base of operations. The guy definitely seemed like quite the expert in scavenging scrap metal, with or without permission, surely. In the right hands, red metal could sell like hotcakes.
That's true.
But Asian Blue, seems like that pig had a name after all.
Right. Okay. Is there anything else?
The rag reeked of fermented vomit.
Very lovely.
Carl wondered how one could bear to live in such gross and horrid conditions.
Your traditional recipe, white whiskey, too much, is a valid qualifier for that, Sherifine, for added mellowness. Okay. Is there anything else? No. Okay, what do we have here?
Rock music invaded the minds of men, even in the remotest of places.
Yeah, some
clothes. Man didn't own a turntable, so there's that one for him.
Also, because... not...
In Africa and elsewhere, people ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost. All a man could do is curse out loud against the faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise. That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock.
Right in.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death.
But was that we needed to give to the old man? I'm not quite sure. But for now, I am gonna take up a couple of logs and some stuff. And I need... Okay, inventory is full. I will come back for those. Oh, great frozen lake. Okay, some dress. Yep. Do we get a cigarette, more cigarettes? And there's that icy mystery again. Gonna take out the camera and a nice picture.
Seen its share of gravel roads.
Okay, there's...
Carl wasn't a mechanic, but he could easily tell that only the most heartfelt prayer would bring this old beater back from its slumber. With that cold, however, it was more likely that it would wait until next spring to wake up. Carl felt that it was mission accomplished with the wicked nectar in his hands.
I don't know anything about cars, so yeah, I am not gonna do anything about that. Gonna go here and put some stuff in my trunk. Oh dear God. Gonna put a couple of cigarettes there. Don't need that many. Like, that's weird that we... Honestly, I don't know. I don't know like what we are going to need or what not, so I don't know exactly what to deposit here. I'm gonna run back to get those last couple of items, and yeah. Okay, I'm gonna drive my car closer, and yes, gonna get the last items. I'm gonna drop out my lantern. Gonna put one log there. Just gonna keep one lock with me all the time. Gonna save up, and then we are gonna see where the wolf path lead us. There has been some fight going on. Like, I can see there's like grass stuff. So there's the ice cave. Hold up, did we have... There's a journal. Do we have the treasure map? There are the photos. Where is the treasure maps? I wanna look at the treasure maps. You see, there was something in the water.
Garbage trucks rarely made a stop in the area.
Maybe I saw something wrong.
There's a pretty good backup dump for those times when the bin started overflowing.
Maybe I saw something wrong. Okay, but the pause. Or from there, okay. Gonna take my hatchet. I'm gonna take the hatchet. Just in case of the wolves. So now we are here, and hopefully it doesn't shoot. It's just me. Yes, I do have actually. Survive in that ice camp.
The old man's cabin had been very generous to Carl. He couldn't have asked for more.
Yes, I am very happy about that too. So we need to go through here. Just gonna go aimlessly through here and hope for the best. It always feels like somebody is walking right next to me. Okay, so here are the wolf barn. Just gonna bring out my hatchet. Yeah, just hunting wolves in the Canadian wilderness. Nothing unusual. Absolutely nothing. So where are we in the map? can survive there. I hope that with this jacket we do. Look at this. Did we pass it? No, maybe not. Start loading it, I think. Hold up. Should be a clear sign to not to go in there. But I don't listen. So now we are just gonna go get right into there. Magically, I built a pretty fridge. We're gonna get bottom of this. My hatchet, yes. There we go. There's something. I can't shit that much. Just gonna hope that I'm not gonna die in here. Thankfully we saved just right outside of that.
Another instance of this magic ice. What was this one doing? Lying on the ground, so afraid. The plot thickened like water into ice. A sudden cold snap struck Carl, who felt like he was pulled into a dream.
Again. This shit again. Okay, great.
He had been running in fear from something creeping towards him, against which he couldn't do anything, only to end up like this, petrified and cold.
And that just so sweet. So what it is, I just hope that nothing attacks me. But we will see that soon. Okay. Also, he had a gun with him. Okay, very interesting. be somebody. Okay, so this was the part that I did not notice.
It seemed as though he had been ready to take up arms and slay people like Hamilton. Could he have committed murder for his cause? Who could have gotten killed in front of his very eyes?
Regents log, page 1, August 8, 1970. Old Rosary had told me the mine administrations were having us on, and that the mines from before the war were neither collapsed nor inaccessible. Well, as
Carl
usual.
How long you would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
As well as usual, the old man was right. Those damn English people keep lying to us every damn day because we're just slaves to them water boys, white negroes. Like Villares said, we'll see who the slaves are by the end of the year. I set up the heart of my government in those mines. The resistance, watch out, fat cats. I'm putting bayonets on our cannons. August 14th, 1970. The English tell us the region is in full on resources. So they're forgetting about is our seniors. It's full of old people around here, and they got plenty of resources. Old man Rosary in exchange for a full load of bottle of caribou a day put us in contact with the best of our country has to offer. Veterans, hunters, and the salt of the earth. I'm telling you, these people have shotguns upon shotguns in blinds of all over the territory. They agreed to lend me some, pretty much no questions asked. Still, I told them the big fat cat hunt was in the works. I also told them that our aim was to make sure there was not a damn one of them left from here to out the Ontario's River. How many pages are there? Just 3, okay. September 1st, 1970. It's even better than I had thought. The guns are an old timely relics from the Great War. There are modern semi-automatic weapons, is there too? A dynamite stolen from the mining sites after closing. All I need now is militia to bear these arms and kick the English out of our lands. I wonder who the savages will back up. I have faith that they will help us and not them. Take it back their land.
He would not hold up much longer. He had to warm himself.
Okay, I'm gonna read them later. Just gonna have to warm myself up. Just gonna need some logs. Some dynamite. Just gonna move that. Yeah, I can't be here much longer. Rifle, but that's pretty neat. Shit. Okay, I'm gonna die here. Just gonna run real fast to the outside. I know Carl. I should have taken more logs. Okay, let's just run outside.
Ice seemed to take over this place like mold. That wall wasn't there earlier. How was he going to get out of here?
Ain't that a great question? Yes, I know, but I need to get out of here.
Carl's scout training was buried deep in his memory. What do you need again to start a fire?
we need more. Gonna get back to my car, which is in that way, I believe so. Yeah, just a little bit over there. Okay. Gonna get to the car and get some stuff out of there. Maybe mainly the logs and put out some stuff that we don't need. And then we go back there again. Get some more logs. Gonna take like 2 or 3 logs. Like, so we'll see. Some wolves. Could you like please get out of my way? I don't want to fight with you. Okay. Now we are ready for this. Okay, we are gonna continue with this one.
Who could have gotten killed in front of his very eyes?
September 4th, 1970. God damn it, Gilles has really has no balls. I was aware of that before bringing him to my project, but it's so insulting to be emasculated like that. He told me in his wimpy voice that he has something to blackmail Big Hamilton with. What's the point of blackmailing him when we could just blow his head off? I would have been better off speaking to his wife, Gilles. Now she's something, that woman, that could hold her own with a shotgun. Besides, everyone knows she's the one who wears the pants in that couple. September 18th, 1970. Lamotte has given up to that coward. On the other hand, the Lamottes, they are not serious enough. They have a few screws loose. You can start revolution with crazy people. September 24th, 1970. Pierre, I know you would have been on my side. You would have been a lieutenant in my army. Rest in peace. Eaten by wolves, not an easy way to kick the bucket. Some people in the village are saying you brought this on yourself by poaching those wolves, and that in the end they just brought you into justice in their own way. There will be a monument.
I wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
In your name, in my new Quebec. September 1970, I have to free the monastery region all by myself. Alexander Blaze didn't appreciate it when I baited him by praising his brother. That guy has changed since Pierre was found. He's been miserable. I tried talking to him about it, but that pig off only punched the mirror and that made his hand bleed. I'll give freedom to my country without those tender-hearted folks. They'll thank me later. October 2nd, 1970. What happened last night was horrible. I'd never see someone die like that. Right next to me, I feel sick. So much blood. I'm wondering if revolution really is for me after all. Right. Now we have read that. And now we can start fire here. And not die horribly. Sounds good. Now take out some stuff. Pillars, some dynamite. Yes. Oh, come on! I feel so stupid now. There is logs right there. I feel so fucking stupid now. Smuggle booze. Yes, I can see that. Oh, is there Coca-Cola? Nice. I sleep at home when you can sleep here, okay? But yeah, good to know that there's logs in here. I was so panicking. So we have... Oh shit, that's a really shaky car. Really, really shaky. Just gonna check out my journal real fast. So there are so many stuff going on. No. Okay, so vandalism, we have. I think that we have covered that up. But we still need something from that crash. I think it's otherwise we need one thing out of that crash, then I think it's done. Gone mystery, yes, we are still missing. I still wonder what that is. I think that we are like jumping here. I met this murderer. We still, yeah, there is so much stuff to go. A young woman, I still wonder who that is. And this is very, very weird, but I think we will get bottom in this. Oh, those are our lovely, lovely pictures. Okay. Good. I don't think that we're gonna need that. Need some light out of here. Yeah, just gonna get out here. But no. Fuck that wall.
This seemed to take over this place like mold. That wall wasn't there earlier. How was he going to get out of here?
I know, but we will. Okay, great. That's just great. Question. I think that we need to go back here.
Carl suddenly felt observed. He was worried about a presence around him.
Yeah, that's worrying me. More, please. Need to smoke a cigar very soon. Can we get out of here? Oh, shoot. That was really loud. But now we are out of here. Yes. Yes. To the light we go.
No stone can withstand the force of dynamite.
Yes, we are out. This is the way that I said that we were like, yes, this is our way out. Good to know. I don't believe that we might have missed something there, so that's good that we can come back in here. I'm gonna check out my map real fast. Can I go and just sit there by the fire for a little bit? Actually, now I think that we're okay. Smoke some cig real fast to calm my nerves. Cause yeah, that's what you are supposed to do. Okay, so our car is right here. Yes, here we go. And now we are gonna drive at the end of this road, I believe so. I'm gonna check out that real fast. Yes, at the end of this road. Yes. That sounds good. Gonna want to check that one cabin over there. What's that? Gonna check that real fast. We desperately need some logs in order to save our game and warm ourselves up. Hold up, did my eyes see? Okay, I saw something. I thought I saw something, but I didn't. Okay. A little bit paranoid, but that's okay. Just gonna leave my car here. Hopefully this guy is friendly.
Sometimes, and especially around here, people are so possessive with their land as a dog is with hydrants.
Dear Mr. Lamos, here is a spark plug you ordered for your Olympic ski too. This model is being very popular, has made it difficult to find a brand new part as quickly as usual. Thank you for choosing the garage spot win and feels in Jimbo Gamow. Silent Gyatham steal some shit. Just hoping that there is no gun pointing to our head when we come here.
What good was a motorless car? The mechanic sure had an odd way to go about repairing things.
Look at the music, has definitely changed us to some. Some locks, okay, good to know. That doesn't sound very good. Oh no, not this shit again. What? There's Hamilton. I don't understand French. Sorry. Snap a biscuit. Yeah, very nice.
It's supposed to soothe the soul.
Yeah.
Powerful gale that seemingly never sleeps. It was far more likely to get on anyone's nerves. Carl had a hunch that there had got to be a plan somewhere that could help him put this thing back together.
Okay. Let's see what this shit is about. Come at first. Not a big fan of the music, is it really? No, not for me. Nope. Okay, let's see what this shit is about.
Another worrisome victim of this ice. This one seemingly petrified in action. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seems to have been defending the entrance to his cabin. But from what?
Well, I think that we are going to find out sooner or later. Okay, some UFO shit is going. Somewhere. Wait a second. What? So they do something there. We're supposed to get it out, or okay, there's something.
Something very important must have been in there for the man to take such time and effort to hide it. But Carl didn't know how to reach it.
Too many hard shares, but okay, great. Just just gonna open that up. That's it.
Shape of this
something
machine, almost straight out of Star Trek, was out of the ordinary to say the least. It felt like this thing could fly up into space at any moment. The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind for him to still keep this around.
All right, then we're just gonna absolutely nothing.
To all appearances, Carl concluded, the owner of the place had moved more essentials from his house inside the garage. Peculiar man indeed.
Can we shut it down? Can we shut it down, please? Apparently not. But that's a boring one.
Machines like this entailed a level of intellectual finesse that Carl was lacking.
Yes, I see. I can see that. There's a headlight. Can I inspect that? Okay, not. Okay. But there's something that can we like. Sure. Now I wanna go and check out that. Can I shoot it from here? Okay, that did absolutely nothing.
The milk was sorted by color, from the whitest to the greenest, or in other words, from the freshest to the sourest.
Right, then. Okay, there's.
Someone was expecting an important call.
Perhaps.
That person's in for a long wait.
Okay, there's
already
a lot of trash.
Provided in this area.
Polaroid film, yes. There's some note.
Roswell, Atamipak, same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies.
Follow up on a complaint. Dear Mr. Lamos, following up on your complaint, I'm afraid that the police cannot support your claim alleging the sudden appearances of a man who came from outer space on your village territory. Manifestly, what happened at Roswell in New Mexico left a deep impression on you, and we would urge you to consult with the police as soon as possible. Regarding future potential complaints, let it be known that the district of ABTP does not believe in a little green man. Regards, Pierre Valéan. Right.
Carl deducted this was a map of the area.
No way.
Pins pointing to places of interest.
All right, we have so much stuff to look for. That's the general store, but we have not been there yet. Like on that secret port project. Oh yes, we are definitely gonna go and check that out in the next episode. But first I wanna check this place out.
A crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves?
Suspension. This suspension has way too many parts. Taking puzzle apart is easy, but putting it back together is another story. I patched everything up, but the tracks, I left them close by. Ski. Don't drink and work. I'm misplacing parts of the machine. Red Cheyenne came to help me work on the machine yesterday afternoon. For the most part, he helped me chuck my bottles down to the last drop. I think we tired to ski or something. Bad idea. I still have found that one ski we lost in the process. Page 2. Body. That would make a nice beach chair pad. I just need to get all the parts to reassemble it. Electrical. This lamp is pretty well made, suitable for use even in the harshest of winters. I think I'll place it on top of my secret prototype in the garage. Space has got to be pitch black and a damn cold after all. Steering. I'll have to hurry up and fix this machine if I'm to travel around the power or snow all winter. Alright, I managed to untangle and replace the brakes cable. Dead on time for October. Now how about a nice and light blanket of early snow to let the fun begin? Notes: December 1969. Stones. They're a blast when you're 12 and you go ahead and break your brother's old bicycle, I suppose. Well, I managed to damage my beautiful brand new snowmobile after only 2 days of aerobatics. Fixing it up will take a while. I'm thinking a year at the very least. Damn it. March 1970. I need to get my hands on that yellow suit, including the helmet that goes with it. Just like to add, I'll order them from the bay. September 1970. I think I'm done. All that's left is install all the parts. Get the spark plug I ordered back in August and I still haven't received. Find the snowmobile in engine key. I think it's on my bunch of keys, which should be on generator power in my top secret workshop down south, in which I'm working on my equally top secret machine. Anyways, gotta find that key. Now that I'm shipbound off the snowmobile's gas to feed my truck, I have to refuel it if I'm to wander in the snow banks at some point. Interesting. Yeah, that's very secretive when you just leave it like laying around here.
These scribblings were undoubtedly the mark of a tormented mind. Something wasn't right in the poor mechanic's head.
Apparently, Lama is a rock collector. Yeah, I can see that. And there are some socks also. Some Coca-Cola also. Of the UFO. But yeah, I think that for now I'm out of time of this episode, but the next time we will most definitely go into that secret project that he has been, and yeah, we will see that there's also somewhere here. Is that if I remember correctly, there is somewhere that treasure hunt also. I need to actually, I'm gonna find that. Like, I really want that. Where is it? I think I lost it. We have every single other thing, but not there's treasure maps. Okay, great. Map 2, 3, and this is the 4th one. Okay, we haven't found the first one, but I think that's fine. Also, I'm like wondering where that is. So the north is there, there's like 4 cabins. Where is the 4 cabins? Like, is it like somewhere up there maybe? Okay, Hamilton's place is over there, okay. And there's some water. I don't think it's that, but that might be where the ice cave boy and the doctor might be. Don't know, but we will find it. Sooner or later. I really want to get to the bottom of this. Yeah, that's about it. I'm just gonna smoke ASMR before you all go and move on with your lives, if that's okay with you. I have this rice thing covered in chocolate, and yeah, I think it makes a really good ASMR. That crunch. So, thank you so much for watching and being here with me. I do not take your time for granted. I truly appreciate you for staying here and watching me and supporting me and my content. Thank you so much for that. And yes, I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.